I get up, I get down, and I'm jumping around. And the rumpus and ruckus are comfortable now. Been a hell of a ride, but I'm thinking it's time to grow. So I got an apartment across from the park. Put quinoa in my fridge, still I'm not feeling great. Been a hell of a ride, but I'm thinking it's time to go.
Here we go.
So put your best face on, everybody pretend you know this song. Everybody come hang, let's go out.
What's up, everyone, and thank you for tuning in to the 2021 Golden Greyhounds Senior Choice Awards. This is the first ever Senior Choice Awards at Loyola, so thank you to the 400 of you who submitted nominations and votes for the 35 different winners of all the senior awards and superlatives we have coming up for you in this video. My name is Spencer Blair. I'm your senior class president and your host throughout the show. And before we recognize some truly interesting, incredible individuals in our Loyola class of 2021, I have a few words to set the tone for the event. Since you've all received so many of my color-coordinated emails over the years, I'm sure you're pretty tired of hearing from me by now, so I promise I'll keep this brief, but there's absolutely no denying that this has not been the senior year that myself, Senior SGA, nor anyone else in our senior class have imagined for ourselves. Literally every single one of our senior class events has been canceled due to the COVID-19 restrictions on campus. Countdown events, canceled. Bull and Oyster, yep, can't happen. And Senior Gala, yeah, you guessed it, that was canceled too. So even this very event that you're watching right now was meant to be a black tie event in which all of the nominees and their friends could come in person to accept their Golden Greyhounds awards. So we haven't really been able to squeeze the sponge because, frankly, there hasn't been even a sponge to squeeze. Even though myself and the rest of Senior SGA are very thankful that we're able to bring this award show to you virtually, nothing can ever replace all that we've lost throughout the past year. Despite all that loss, the pandemic can never take away all the memories that we made in our normal times at Loyola. Like dinners at Boulder, conversations with our friends on the humanities porch, sitting out on the quad in the sun, going out on a night in Fed, riding the Bullet PBR, the Hopkins Loyola lacrosse games, the sophomore send-off, that's right, I'm still plugging it 2 years later, and so much more. The pandemic can also never take away the truly incredible makeup of our Loyola class of 2021. Whether you came back to Baltimore or stayed at home throughout this past year, every single one of us make up the best class in Loyola history. And I'm not just saying that. I mean, think about it. We've experienced more adversity than any class in Loyola history, and yet we were still able to make the most out of our last year at Loyola. So instead of focusing on what we've lost, this award show is a celebration of our incredible class, the truly special individuals within it, the relationships we form with one another, and the memories we've made all together. So I think I've said enough. And with that, let's head over to the McManus Theater where Venus will kick us off with our first award.
This is going to be a very entertaining night of awards. So we'll start things off by recognizing the most entertaining member of the class of 2021. The first award is granted to a Loyola senior who literally everybody is excited to see on a night out. This individual has probably mastered riding the mechanical bull at PBR and is always the life of the party, while also making sure everyone has a good time. And let me tell you, if you go out with any of these five nominees, you'll most definitely have a great night. And the nominees for most entertaining are Pat Agresti, Abby Almonte, Claire Corcoran, Mary Claire George, and Brendan O'Brien. And the winner is Mary Claire George.
I'm Claire Corcoran.
I'm Mary Claire George.
I'm Abby Almonte.
And we're here to thank you for this wonderful nomination of Most Entertaining.
A vote for one
is a vote for all. We'd like to thank, most importantly, I want to thank the bartender at Mosaic for kicking me out when I asked him, what can $2 get me around here?
I would like to thank Miss Ivanda from Starbucks and my mom, my dad, the academy, and my cohorts in the class of 2021.
And I would like to thank Connor Lothar for taking me to the ER when I broke my ankle safety legging at power plant.
So, we can't thank you enough, Loyola, and relying on us. And remember, this is the most entertaining. Who would have thought?
Who would have thought?
Now we go from hitting the town to hitting the books because this next award is granted to the Loyola senior who epitomizes the word scholar. To achieve their 4.0 GPA,
This brainiac spends more time in the library than their own dorm room. This individual truly makes the most out of their education by dedicating themselves to scholarship. Some may call them a genius, while others may call them a total nerd. But either way, they'll probably make more money than all of us anyway, so who cares what we call them? The nominees for Most Intelligent are Jack Carney, Sabrina Daglish, Liam O'Grady, Catherine Sanders, and Sean Scott. And the winner is Catherine Sanders.
Hey everyone, it's Catherine Sanders. Thank you so much for nominating and voting me for the Golden Greyhound Most Intelligent Award. It is so kind of any of you who considered me for this award, but I definitely would have not gotten to this point senior year without the help of some of my incredible friends, especially those in Sellinger Scholars, and of course my friends in my major, Marketing and Information Systems. So thank you all so much for being part of my Loyola journey and being really a constant support system along the way. I also want to shout out some of my favorite mentors and professors from Loyola who have been incredibly kind, caring, and encouraging over the past 4 years. This includes, but definitely I'm missing some, Professor Yeh, Professor London, Professor Crail, Dr. Schmidt-King, and Professor Wagner, and of course many more. Thanks again to the entire class of 2021. This award really warmed my heart and really made me smile. So thank you all. Go out.
Keeping with the theme of making the most of our Jesuit education, the next award is granted to the Loyola senior who is a member of seemingly every single Loyola club or organization. This person's Outlook calendar is absolutely jam-packed, and they are often asked, "How do you do it all?" by their fellow students. The nominees for most involved are Spencer Blair, Regina McCoy, Liam McDonald, Catherine Sanders, and Nikki Wieman. And the winner is Spencer Blair.
What's up, everyone? Thank you for voting me as most involved. I promise I did not create this SGA event just so that I could win an award. But on a more serious note, this award truly does mean so much to me, and I feel honored to be receiving this recognition. I first want to shout out all my fellow nominees for this award, Catherine Sanders, Liam McDonald, Nikki Wieman, and Regina McCoy, who are all super involved and incredible student leaders in their own right. I would also like to thank all my homies in the Sounder Scholars Program, all my teammates on America's Team, aka Loyola Club Baseball, don't forget it. All my fellow senior RAs, especially my SRA and one of my best friends, Franklin Parks, who actually happens to live above me, so he's probably hearing me shout him out right now. But lastly, I'd also like to thank my Equalize team, which is also made up of three of my best friends, two of whom I've already mentioned, Brennan O'Connell, Catherine Sanders, and Franklin Parks, who all put in incredible time and effort towards serving the Baltimore small business community with me throughout this past year. And finally, I'd like to thank all you watching. I'd like to thank the Loyola class of 2021. Serving as your class president throughout the past 4 years has been the most impactful involvement I've had at Loyola by far, and it has most definitely been the highlight of my college experience. I know some of the events and initiatives that my assembly and I created were more memorable than others, but I truly cannot thank you all enough for sticking with me by voting for me year after year, and you know, for just providing constant support that kept me going amidst all the stress and long hours. I'm incredibly sad that I wasn't able to do more for you all throughout this past year. Honestly, senior year would have been unforgettable if it wasn't for the pandemic, but you know, we've definitely made the best out of our last year. And you know, I hope this award show is a way to end senior year on a high note. To conclude, I want to reiterate that serving as your class president has been an honor and a privilege. We are truly such an incredible group of individuals, and I have been so proud to represent the best class in Loyola history. I love you all. I wish you all the best for what's to come after graduation. And if you've ever read one of my class emails, you know what I'm going to say to end my speech. Roll on.
Being involved in the Loyola community not only includes being immersed in it through clubs and organizations, but it also means being totally invested in proudly representing Greyhound Nation. The next award is granted to the Loyola senior who is most likely to be seen on a Loyola billboard or an advertisement. As the class of 2021's Loyola poster child, this individual bleeds green and gray
and will probably get the words "Roll Hounds" tattooed on their body at some point. The nominees for Most School Spirited are Spencer Blair, Camille Marsdale, Sam Muirhead, Matt Sklar, and Colin Ward. And the winner is Sam Muirhead.
Hey everybody, how's it going? Sam Muirhead here. Just want to say thank you guys for nominating me for Most School Spirit. Just want to show you guys, I'm in my bathroom right now. I got the Loyola flag in my bathroom. Every day I come in here, I look at that flag and I think about the 4 years that we've shared together and every single one of you guys. And that just brightens my day every day. So thank you so much for the nomination and go Hounds.
While academics and extracurriculars are incredibly important, the whole reason we pay all this money to go to college is to get a great job in the real world. However, in most cases, the degree you get doesn't mean much unless you have a solid professional network. So this next award is granted to the Loyola senior who takes the ancient art of networking to the next level. We all know someone who has a LinkedIn premium account and a profile with 500 plus connections and post more on LinkedIn than they do on Instagram or Twitter. The nominees for most time spent on LinkedIn are Morgan Flotterin, Brendan O'Connell, Ben Oswald, Catherine Sanders, and Gabby Senna. And the winner is Ben Oswald.
Hi everyone, I want to thank you so much for nominating me for most time spent on LinkedIn. Throughout the past 4 years here, I've gotten to know many of you and also connected with many of you on LinkedIn, and I hope to keep that going. Definitely reach out to me on LinkedIn. I look forward to also connecting with you. It's a great resource and a great tool to use not only in the business world, but for any of your majors that you recently graduated from. Congratulations to the class of 2021. I look forward to seeing many of you down the road at Loyola alumni events. Best of luck, Godspeed.
After spending 4 years as Loyola students, we know that the Loyola experience is just as much about meeting new people and forming new relationships as it is about getting good grades, being involved, and being prepared for the professional world. This next award is granted to the most outgoing Loyola senior. This individual is seemingly friends with everyone and has never met a stranger. No matter who they run into, they will always make sure to say hello with a smile. Together, the five nominees for this award probably know the entire Loyola community. The nominees for Most Friendly are Abby Almonte, Spencer Blair, Liam McDonald, Venus Okwuka, and Kathleen Shepherd. And the winner is Venus Okwuka.
Hi everyone, thank you so much for voting me for Most Friendly for the class 2021 Golden Greyhounds. I'm sure a lot of you are thinking in your rooms right now, how did she get this award? She is so mean. But you know what they say, tough love is the best love. I want to thank my parents for making me an extreme people pleaser and causing me to believe that everyone has to like me. And I want to thank the Evergreen program for giving me so many meal points that everyone wanted to be my friend anyway. Have a great rest of your lives. I'll probably never talk to you again. Go Hounds.
Speaking of saying hello with a smile, this next award is granted to the Loyola senior with the best set of pearly whites. This individual truly has the type of smile that you can recognize from miles away. The nominees for Best Smile are Cam Amador, Mark Kochikaru, Grace Gautier, Zach Kruger, and Sean Scott. And the winner is Cam Amador.
Hi, everyone. If you're watching this, I guess I won Best Smile. So I just first want to say thank you all so much for considering me for this. It really, really means a lot, and I never thought I'd be considered for this, for the school. There are a lot of amazing smiles out there, and I'm so glad and appreciative that you guys thought of me for this, so thank you. First off, I just want to say thank you to my friends, my family, everyone who supported me the past 4 years. And lastly, the class of 21. One thing rings true is that you guys give me a reason to smile every single day these past 4 years. And even if we didn't have many interactions with each other, you've made my college experience all the better. So thank you so much. I hope to made you smile at least one or two points here. And I can't wait to graduate with you guys. I love you all. And see you on the stage soon. See ya.
Moving from the pearly whites to the luscious locks, this next award is granted to the Loyola senior with the best head of hair. This individual simply has an insane mane or some fantastic flow. The nominees for best hair are Sam Brown, freshman year, Patricia Oates, Kirsten Peterson, Brenny Scheisler, and Mariella Tanney. And the winner is Sam Brown and his freshman year hair.
Thanks for the nomination of best hair. It's clearly not for my hairstyle currently, but I guess some people may have missed my old hair. Personally, I did not, because I learned very quickly that short hair is much more easy to deal with than long hair, but still, thanks again for the nomination.
Nothing complements an amazing smile or great hair more than a stylish outfit. So this next award is granted to the Loyola senior with the most drip. In other words, this individual has some incredible fashion sense and always dresses to impress. Personally, I'm trying to expand my fashion sense beyond vineyard vines and sweatpants, so I'm definitely going to be reaching out to the five nominees for some tips to upgrade my wardrobe. The nominees for best dressed are Malachi Emanuel, Peter Friedrichs, Gabba Horkus, Amelia Salvatore, and Julia Sakura. And the winner is, who else would it be? Amelia Salvatore.
Okay. Thanks so much, class of 2021. I'd like to thank my mom, my grandma, my sisters, all of whom have let me steal their clothes. I'd like to thank my friends for letting me style them whenever we have anything to go to. And yeah, that's it. Woohoo!
These next two awards are granted to the most talented male or female performing artists in Loyola's class of 2021. The individuals that win these awards have a clear passion for music and have either mastered an instrument or have an angelic singing voice. The male nominees for this award include a DJ, I wonder who that could be, a drummer from Loyola's favorite band, Juniper, a rapper who has performed at Loyola Palooza, and two singers from Loyola's Chimes. The nominees for Best Male Performing Artists are Gianni, DJ Gianni Glow Feliciano. Johnny McClay, The Chimes.
I was walking down the street when out the corner of my eye saw a pretty little thing approaching me.
Alejandro Marin, Juniper. Brendan Sweeney, The Chimes. My boy, Jeff Jace Ford Wooten. And the winner is Gianni Glow Feliciano.
What's going on, class of 2021? Thank you so much for nominating me for Best Male Performing Artist at the university. Being a part of the scene here in Baltimore has been absolutely amazing. It's only helped my love for music, DJing, and live performance grow. The relationships I've created and the support I've received over the years has been incredible. So shout out to anyone that's came to see me play live, that's shared one of my mixes, or just shown love in general. The road doesn't stop here. I got a lot more in store, and wherever I'll be, I'll always be repping Loyola. So thank you. Love you guys, and roll out.
The female nominees for this award include 5 singers in total, 4 from the Bells and 1 singer from Loyola's Chapel Choir. Now, if we were lucky enough to have Loyola Palooza this year, one of these ladies might have had the honor to open up for Drake, I mean our top secret 2021 Palooza artist. The nominees for Best Female Performing Artist are Cam Bezdek, The Bells.
Find hope in a hopeless, pull me out the train of rain.
Emma Crowley, The Bells.
I wanna give you wild love, the kind that never slows down.
Grace Gautier, The Bells.
Although it hurts, I'll be the first to say that you were wrong.
Marley Teachout, The Bells.
People keep talking, they can say what they like, but all I know is everything's gonna be alright.
And Emily Zimmerman, Chapel Choir.
It's time for us to become people of love. It's time for us.
And the winner is Emma Crowley.
The kind that never slows down.
Hi, I am so honored to be receiving this nomination for Best Female Performing Artist. Music has always been so important to me, and I've been singing for as long as I can remember, so I'm very grateful to be recognized for something that I'm so passionate about. And I'm so lucky that I was able to come to Loyola and share my voice with others, and I've also met so many wonderful people that have the same passion and love to sing as much as I do, so I'm truly blessed. Thank you very much.
Speaking of performing artists, this wouldn't be an award show without a musical performance or two. So before we get to the rest of our awards, give it up for the Loyola Chimes, who will be performing one of their songs from this year's Chord Busters, which you can check out by heading over to the Loyola Chimes YouTube channel after the show is over.
Roll the dice and have some faith.
be falling in love as she's walking away. When your heart won't tell your mind to tell your mouth what it should say. May have lost this battle, live to fight another day. Don't be falling in love as she's walking away. And have some faith. Don't be falling in love as she's walking away. When your heart won't tell your mind to tell your mouth what it should say. May I lost this battle, live to fight another day. Don't be falling in love as she's walking away.
Thank you to the Loyola Chimes for that wonderful performance, and we will be joined by the Bells in a little bit for their performance. If you enjoy singing more than dancing, you're going to be excited about this next award, which is granted to the Loyola senior who was born to dance, whether it be the whip, the nene, or the whoa. This individual has the dancing feet at Power Plant every Thursday night. The nominees for Best Dancer are Abby Almond. Anna Garzón.
Tell me you love me.
Jamie Gilaretto. And Franklin Parks.
How to duck, taste me how to duck, taste me how to duck, taste me how to duck,
everybody love me, everybody love me, everybody love me, you ain't messing with my duck.
And the winner for best dancer is Abby Almonte.
Hey everyone, thank you so much for voting me for best dancer. You know, my parents realized at a really early age that I was horrible at any sport that involved kicking, throwing, or catching a ball. So those are out of the question, and it's kind of been dance ever since I was two. So definitely want to thank all of my childhood neighbors who endured all of my Britney Spears concerts growing up. I choreographed a lot of those. I definitely want to thank my older brother for distracting my parents so that I could choreograph different T-Pain dances based off his music videos. That was huge. And then I also want to thank everyone in Loyola Dance Company for allowing me to continue like hip-hopping around through college. That's been so fun. And lastly, I just want to thank Mike Duggan for letting me know that my clap and crump three times move is probably outdated, and I'm gonna work on that. So thanks again, guys.
Moving from tearing it up on the dance floor to tearing it up in the athletic competition, these next two awards are granted to the most talented male and female Loyola seniors who represented Greyhound Nation in the pool or on the field, court, or track. The male student athlete nominees represent the men, Loyola men's lacrosse team, the Loyola men's basketball team, and the Loyola men's swimming and diving team. The nominees for best male senior athlete are Isaiah Hart, men's basketball. Kevin Lindley, men's lacrosse. Stephen Matrick, men's swimming and diving. Aiden Olmsted, men's lacrosse. And Adam Wagner, men's lacrosse. And the winner is Isaiah Hart.
Hello, Loyola community. First and foremost, I would like to thank God for giving me the ability to play this game. Without him, none of this is at all possible. With that being said, I would also like to thank all of my supporters. You guys were my motivation on days that I didn't feel like giving it my all. With that being said, I am honored to be nominated for this award. It's good to see that, you know, the hard work that you put in is recognized and enjoyed by others. Thank you.
The female student athlete nominees represent women's lacrosse, women's soccer, women's swimming and diving, and the track and field team. The nominees for best female senior athlete are Julia Gray, women's soccer, Morgan Hall, women's swimming and diving, Caitlin Larson, women's lacrosse, Livy Rosenzweig, women's lacrosse, and Danielle Spano, track and field. And the winner is Morgan Hall.
Hey Hounds, thank you so much for the nomination for Best Female Senior Athlete. I have to say, I'm surprised. If you know me as a swimmer, you would know that I've never been nominated for any sort of athletic award because I can probably count the number of points I've scored for the team on my fingers and toes. Well, maybe a few more than that, but honestly, I've loved competing for the Greyhounds the past 4 years. I've loved equally that Loyola has given me the opportunity to be a whole person, a Salinger Scholar, a SAC Executive Board Member, and many other opportunities outside of the pool. One qualification that might actually make me deserving of this award is I can guarantee without a doubt is I'm the senior female athlete who swam the most laps at the FAC in the past 4 years. My events are the mile, which is 66 laps, the 1,040 laps, and the 520 laps, and that's not including practices. So anyways, a huge shout out to my amazing teammates, coaches, and friends in and out of the pool who have always cheered me on. I'm so grateful to be here.
This next award is granted to the Loyola senior who is known by their nickname instead of their real name. In fact, if you refer to the people in this following list, most people won't recognize them unless you refer to them by their nickname. For a lot of you viewers, this will be the first time you actually find out the real name of some of these nominees. So the nominees for best nickname are Madeline Mev Busconi, Michael Dirty Mike D'Elia, Chase Chiggy Freeman, Garrett Face Palazzo, and Owen Butter Spellman. And the winner is Owen Butter Spellman.
Hello, I'm Owen Spellman, known by most as Butter. Some might not even know my real name. I gained the nickname by my roommate Pat Agresti saying that I look like a stick of butter. So I guess I would like to thank Pat for that nickname, and then also my parents for making me look like a stick of butter.
Coincidentally, one of the nominees for this award has a pretty well-known nickname themselves.
If your viewers out there don't know who Sklar is talking about, then you're about to find out, because this award is granted to a group of female Loyola seniors who are all attached at the hip.
This group of 3 to 6 queens goes everywhere together and are always matching in some way.
The nominees for Best Girl Gang are Julia McMahon, Jill Alita, Emily Kirkpatrick, Liza Burke, Ione Bartlett, and Sophie Hall, otherwise known as the Smoochies.
Maeve Gilbert, Isabella Luciano, Amanda Scorziello, Amanda Mason, and Julianne Rainolo.
Megan Atkinson, Kaylee Walls, Gabby Valentine, and Lauren Bernier.
Danielle Bayani, Erica Faderman, Cecilia Wall, and Emma Snyder.
And Madison Hughes, Anna Hannes, MacKenzie Knox, and Kaylin Malmquist. And the winners are
Maddie Hughes,
Anna Hannes,
MacKenzie Knox,
and Kaylin Malmquist.
Shout out to all 4,000 of you
for voting for us.
We're here, we're in our best formal attire to say thank you for voting for us for Loyola's Best Girl Gang.
Now take a look at the past 4 years.
And watch it take 10 years off of our lives.
Hey Mattel, man, wake up, man, come on. You over there asleep, but I'm lit right now, man. Get up, get up. Boy, get up because I'm so lit right now. Okay, okay, okay.
As the guy standing next to me and I know, there's no question that the best type of romance is a bromance.
This next award honors just that, and it's for the two male seniors that do everything together to the point where people think they're related.
This dynamic duo may skip out on date night for a movie night with the bros.
The nominees for best bromance are Cam Amador and Jared Longo,
Solomon Dorsey and Aki Maha,
Derek Morales and Ben Pazienza,
Dylan Nikaj and Riley Chin,
and Franklin Parks and Spencer Blair.
And the winner is
Cam Amador and Jared Longo.
Jared, we gotta get ready for the video. We gotta do bromance, like right now.
Oh, God damn it.
That's kind of funny.
Hi, my name's Jared.
I'm Jared.
I'm Cam.
Okay.
Right.
We'd like to say thank you. And that's about it.
Yeah, thank you guys for voting for us. It was a fun award to win. If you're watching us, I guess we won. So thank you all so much. Couldn't have done it without you. And we're just here to break the stigma that we are, in fact, not cousins. If any of you still out there believe that.
Sorry about that.
It was a freshman year joke, guys. Get over it.
Went a little far.
Otherwise, we're happy to be here. We're great pals, me and this guy. Great, great friends. We came here from high school, and we heard the thing that, like, you know, sometimes it doesn't always work out when you room with someone you know from school previously, but it ended up working out pretty well. And I'd say we got the full college experience from it.
So thank you guys, appreciate it.
Yeah, we love you all. Thank you, Loyola, and see you on the stage in a couple weeks.
Now we move from one award about a dynamic duo to another.
Love is in the air because this next award is granted to the two Loyola seniors with the best romantic relationship. People often describe this couple as goals, and hey, maybe they'll even come back and get married at the Loyola Chapel. Probably not, but that would be nice.
For all my single people out there, let's all hope that we someday find a love like these five couples have so that we do not end up alone.
And the nominees for cutest couple are Amelia Salvatore and Joe Correo, Cecilia Wall and Matt Zamo, Kate Hughes and Matt Zavallo, Nicole Rivas and Turner Wilforth, and Patricia Oates and Connor Lothar. And the winner is Amelia Salvatore and Joe Correo.
Thank you for voting for us. I'd like to thank Amelia for being my girlfriend.
And I'd like to thank Joe for being my boyfriend. And a fun fact is that we actually met in literature class with Professor Andrew Bossert, and Joe is still in my phone as Joe from literature.
And I'd like to thank Liam, my brother man.
Now that we've identified the cutest couples of Loyola's class of 2021, it's time to find out the cutest couple that never was.
This award is granted to the two Loyola seniors who should have dated but never did.
These two individuals are destined to be soulmates, even though they both don't know it yet.
This award could even be considered as a way to get them to go on their first date, or a way to embarrass them enough to make them never want to talk again and become the couple that never will be. Hopefully, it'll be the first one. The nominees for cutest couple that never was are Juliana Bono and Richard Dixon,
Madeline Buscone and Connor DeVos,
Venus Okwuka and Michael D'Elia,
Catherine Sanders and Brendan O'Connell,
and Emma Toomey and Jack Gannon. And the winners are Venus Okwuka
and Mike D'Elia.
Hi, Loyola. We wanted to thank you so much for your nomination that in honor of the Evergreens, the tri-state area, we got hitched.
So now you can never say that we're the cutest couple that never was, because we actually are. My maid of honor is Devon Garner, and the groomsman is Claire Corcoran, and the officiant is Liam O'Grady.
Can't wait to see you all there at the chapel.
In regards to things I will never be, let's hope the subject of this next award is included in that. This next award, most likely to win a Loyola version of the Hunger Games, is definitely the most unique of the night. For those of you that live under a rock and have never read the books, The Hunger Games basically involves 24 randomly selected young adults who are forced to fight to the death in an arena for everyone in the world to watch on TV. So, this award is granted to the Loyola senior who epitomizes survival of the fittest. This individual's perseverance, resourcefulness, and love for the outdoors would allow them to outlast everyone else in the class of 2021 during the Hunger Games. The nominees for most likely to win a Loyola version of the Hunger Games are Michael D'Elia, Jack Drangwitz, Ava Haig, Grace Hominy, and Brendan O'Brien. And the winner is Michael D'Elia.
When we talk about the world changing, I don't think any of us are talking about an event from a fantasy book coming to reality. However, the positive change that the five nominees for this next award could bring about in the world is very real. This next award is granted to the Loyola senior who will do the most to make the world a better place beyond graduation. Whether this individual joins the Peace Corps, discovers the cure for cancer, or invents the next Microsoft, they will make a tremendous positive impact on global society. The five nominees for this award are truly incredible individuals who are passionate about finding solutions to problems and making the world a better place. The nominees for most likely to change the world are Justin Du, Kiva Mannion, Brendan O'Connell, Ava Haig, and Sophia Riviello. And the winner is Ava Haig. Congratulations.
For this superlative, I am incredibly honored and grateful to the Loyola Class of 2021. I've always had a passion for helping people and trying to do better in my community, but coming to Loyola and being a part of this thriving, supportive community has inspired me to go so much further and really commit to working for what I believe in. While I was chosen for this superlative, I truly believe that everyone who steps into the Loyola community will change the world in one way or another. And in life after college, I hope to really inspire others and do good no matter where in life takes me. Thank you again so very much and happy graduation.
Changing the world is no easy task whatsoever, but being elected President of the United States may help make that a little easier. The next award is granted to the Loyola senior who is most likely to be voted in as Commander-in-Chief of our nation one day.
This individual most likely has passion for public policy and political activism, which allows them to have what it takes to be able to unite the citizens of our country. Or they could just be our current senior class president, a political science major, or Liam McDonald, who's been nominated for almost every award already.
From one current president to another potential president, the nominees for most likely to be president of the United States are Spencer Blair, James Burke, Nathan Cunning, Liam McDonald, and Matt Repko. And the winner is
Matt Repko.
Good evening, my fellow Americans.
I am not here today to present a Gettysburg Address or a Berlin Wall speech. Instead, I am here to thank you, my fellow classmates, for nominating me most likely to be President of the United States. It is an honor to be nominated amongst peers with outstanding integrity and morals. Moreover, I hope you will recall this moment far down the road when I come looking for a donation to my campaign. May God bless you and your families, and may God bless the United States of America.
When I was 10 years old, I looked 5 years old. When I was 15, I looked 10. I'm almost a 23-year-old man, and I still can't grow a beard. Once I came to Loyola, I realized that this was a bigger problem than I expected. Bartenders would laugh, bouncers would throw me out, and even Hopkins Deli asked for identification. Today, I'm honored to present the award that is granted to the Loyola senior who is most definitely going to be carded at our 10-year reunion. This individual already looks young and will look exactly the same in 10 years. But hey, at least we will look cute when Spencer has receding hairlines and bad knees. The nominees for most likely to be ID'd at the age of 30 are Robert Chambers, Molly Dion, Gracie Marino, Derek Morales, and Dylan Wilsberg. And the winner is Mr. Robert Chambers.
Hi, everyone. Thank you to all the people who voted for me for most likely to be ID'd at age 30. I'm not sure exactly whether this is supposed to be a compliment, but when I'm 30, I'm sure it will be a compliment. So hopefully I can live up to the expectations, and we'll see if I get ID'd at one of our reunions. Thanks again.
Youth has its perks, especially when it comes to being an influencer. Our generation has grown up with social media, so it's no surprise that the Loyola Class of 2021 has some potential future viral superstars. The next award is granted to the Loyola senior who is most destined to become TikTok famous, an Instagram model, or a YouTube vlogger with millions of subscribers. This individual was born to be in the spotlight, has probably mastered the renegade, and always finds the right angles for photos. The nominees for most likely to become an influencer are Michael Yost, Kayla Keach, Kyla Lamb, Kirsten Peterson, and Taylor Surface. And the winner is Kyla Lamb.
Hi guys, thank you for nominating me for most likely to become an influencer. I just wanna give a shout out to all my girls and everyone who made my Loyola experience what it was. A little plug on my Instagram at Kylie Lamb, and can't wait to see all of you guys at graduation.
Unfortunately, not all of us are lucky enough to make millions of dollars being an influencer. Most of us have to work traditional jobs, and the five nominees for this next award may even find themselves working at Loyola in a few years. This next award is granted to a senior who will come back to work at Loyola because 4 years just wasn't enough for them. This individual will still be seen walking around campus while the rest of us bring our children back for a college visit. The nominees for most likely to work at Loyola are Molly Dion, Francisco Echaniz, Ben Oswald, Julia Scapp, and Kaylee Walls. And the winner is Kaylee Walls.
Loyola Class of 2021, it's me, Kaylee Walls here, and I just wanted to say thank you for the nomination for most likely to work at Loyola. A senior year here on campus is wrapping up. I'm noticing that 4 years just wasn't quite enough for me. So I would be more than happy to come back to Loyola one day to work here. Thanks so much for the nomination. Love you guys all, and congratulations on graduation.
What's up, everyone? It's me again. Don't worry, the show is almost over because we only have 10 more awards to present. But before we get to those, let's give it up for the Loyola Bells, who, just like the Chimes earlier in the show, will perform one of their songs from this year's Chord Busters.
Sunshine, we'll shine together. Told you I'll be here forever. Said I'll always be your friend. You can stand under my umbrella. Hello.
Disturbia. I'm a scary new tonight. Disturbia. Ain't used to what you like. Disturbia. Disturbia.
Come, Mr. DJ, stop on every play. Mr. DJ, won't you turn the music up? All the girls on the dance floor want it some more.
I can assure you all that we are not spilling any tea by telling you the date for this year's Chordbusters, because the Bells and Chimes were kind enough to let us promote the event. However, I don't know if we can say the same about the five nominees for this next award, which is granted to the Loyola senior who is the biggest gossip. This individual knows something about everyone, so they are practically the number one news source for all the rumors and drama circulating around campus. I mean, somebody's got to keep the people informed, right? The nominees for most likely to spill the tea are James Burke, Colleen Gehan, Kath Moynihan, Venus Okwuka, and Emma Toomey. And the winner is Venus Okwuka.
Hey, Sklar, what's up?
Yeah, I have a second. I'm alone, yeah. I can obviously keep a secret. Oh, I won't spill the tea. That's it? That's surprising, honestly. Yeah, I won't tell Spencer you told me. He's on the other line. I'll call you back. Hey, Spencer, how's it going? Yeah. I once filled the tea, no way. Wait, I'm so shocked. I know, I really had no clue I was gonna get it. Okay, yeah, I'll send you my video. I'll pretend like it's a surprise. All right, talk to you later, bye-bye. Oh, if they only knew. How sweet. Thanks, y'all.
While the five nominees for this next award may not spill the tea, they will never fail to remind the professor that they forgot to assign homework to the class. This next award is granted to the individual who always sits in the front of the class and writes absurdly long answers to Moodle post discussions. The nominees for Biggest Teacher's Pet are Maddie Brenner, Ben Oswald, Katherine Sanders, Emma Schiller, and Sean Scott. And the winner is Ben Oswald.
Hi, everyone. I wanted to thank you so much for nominating me for Teacher's Pet here, a part of the class of 2021. definitely throughout the classroom, I want to apologize for those really long discussion boards and sometimes maybe reminding the professor that we had homework, but just know that I really enjoyed having a lot of classes with you. It's definitely been a great 4 years here. I'm so excited to continue to learn in my job after Loyola, and so should you. Learning, I've been told, is certainly a lifelong habit to get into, and so it just doesn't end here at Loyola. Best of luck to the class of 2021. No matter where you're heading after your time here at Loyola, you're destined for greatness, and I want to thank you so much for the past 4 years.
I'm pretty sure that rats normally aren't considered pets, but that doesn't really matter anyway, because this next award features a figurative rat, a fact rat, if you will. Like I said, this next award is granted to the senior who practically lives at Loyola's Fitness and Aquatic Center. The gym rat loves to pump some iron and definitely never skips leg day. The nominees for biggest fact rat are John Cottingham, Nick Febo, Hannah Grinblatis, Dylan Nakaj, and Matt Robbins. And the winner is John Cottingham.
Wow, fact rat, what an honor. I'll be honest, I was surprised when I got the nomination for this award, since personally I don't consider myself one of the biggest or strongest guys at the fact. But it makes me happy that over the past 4 years, people have noticed all the hard work I've been putting in. And I'm really thankful for all the people who nominated me. But I also want to thank a few other people, including a bunch of my gym partners over the past couple of years. Firstly, Kyle Dugaitis. He's been my day one gym partner since our freshman year at Loyola. He's helped take the weight off me more times than not, and even helped me start Loyola Barbell. Some other gym partners I want to thank, like Brendan O'Connor, Peter Friedrichs, Pat Carroll, and Nick Lynn. And lastly, I want to thank Leticia Burns over the fact she's been instrumental in helping get Loyola Barbell started and keeping it going over the past 2 years. But most importantly, I just want to tell you guys, keep grinding the gym. Let's get those gains this semester.
The five nominees for the next award are diehard Loyola sports fans. So they've probably made their way up to the fact to cheer on the swimming and diving team from time to time. More specifically, this award is granted to the Loyola senior who lives and breathes Greyhound sports. This individual can be found leading chants in the front row of Ridley during lacrosse games and annually trying to convince everyone that this is our year when talking about basketball teams making it to March Madness. The nominees for the biggest Hounds superfans are Sam Merhead, Camille Marsdale, Colin Ward, Matt Repko, and John Cottingham. And the winner is Camille Marsdale.
Hi, everybody. Thank you so much for nominating me for Biggest Hounds Superfan. I have a few people that I would like to thank. First of all, my mom and dad for sending me to Loyola. It's a wonderful place. I'd also like to thank Becca Winkler, who is the moderator for the Superfans Executive Board. Been with her since my freshman year. She's been a great mentor for me. I'd also like to thank the Superfans Executive Board, Colin Ward, who is the Vice President, who has been my partner in crime. And I'd also like to give a shout out to the first years who I started Superfans with my freshman year, Kate Freeman, Brianna McHugh, Sam Muirhead, and also Colin. But thank you, everybody, and congrats on graduating, and I hope that everyone has the best of luck in their future.
Just as the nominees for the last award love to hype up Loyola sports, the nominees for this next award love to hype up their fellow members of the class of 2021. This award is granted to the Loyola senior who will hype you up whether you know them or not. This wholesome individual lives to make people feel good about themselves and is always there to support anyone who needs it. If you're ever having a bad day or feeling bad about yourself, you'll want to hope that you run into one of the five nominees for this award. The nominees for Biggest Hype Person are Abby Almonte, Amelia Layton, Franklin Parks, and Angel Prado. And the winner is Franklin Parks.
Hey
a huge thank you to those who nominated me and to those who voted for me as biggest hype person. I just try to spread positivity and to make people feel good about themselves. So I love to spread love and compliments to everybody that I'm in close contact with, because I don't know the struggle that they're going through. And I just love to just make others feel great about themselves, because I would want someone to do the same thing to me and compliment me. So I appreciate everybody who voted for me. And even if you didn't, thank you for being a wonderful person. Thank you.
This next award is very personal to me. I'm actually in class as we speak and have four assignments due at 11:59 tonight. For procrastinators, we suffer from senioritis every single year, and finals week is when we learn an entire semester's work in a couple of hours. The next award is granted to the Loyola senior who has mastered the art of procrastination. This individual pulls an all-nighter on the reg, considers deadlines to be mere suggestions, and lives by the mantra, "I'll do it tomorrow." The nominees for Biggest Procrastinator are Justin Ackerman, Francisco Echaniz, Brendan Hayes, and Jack O'Neill. And the winner is Justin Ackerman.
What's up, everyone? Thanks for voting me for the Biggest Procrastinator. I proved that you can do 8 classes in 1 week. I also procrastinated for like 3 weeks recording this video. So thanks, everybody.
Most would agree that learning how to manage procrastination is simply a necessary part of a student's first year at Loyola. So is learning how to manage a schedule to be able to make it to everyone's favorite Baltimore establishment, Power Plant Live, every Thursday night during their first year at Loyola. Many try, but only a few succeed, and this next award honors the senior who is able to accomplish this truly impressive and glorious feat, which requires incredible dedication and time management, or just an utter disregard for responsibilities and academics. Did this individual peak after freshman year? Probably. Did they have an incredible time? Absolutely. The nominees for the prestigious honor of receiving the Forever a First Year Award are James Burke, Chase Freeman, Allie Hassel, Dylan Nakaj, and Brian Parsons. And the winner is Dylan Nakaj.
Alright, hey guys. You guys told me that this is my home, that I'm forever a first year, and you know what? You guys are right. I am forever a first year. I will live in Power Plant forever. This is the greatest place of all time. You can't tell me anything different. You know, make sure you guys rage on Thursday nights. Let's go.
Before we get serious to end the night, let's try to have a laugh. This award goes to the funniest Loyola senior, so these nominees will have no problem letting us do that. These nominees are destined to be a comedian one day, and they are always cracking jokes and know how to make a fool of themselves in order to make everyone around them laugh. The nominees for Class Clown are Claire Corcoran, Dave Giacobo, Brendan Hayes, Sam Muirhead, and Brendan O'Brien. And the winner is Dave Giacobo.
Hi guys, it's David Giacobo here, also known as the kid that lived with all girls his senior year of college. I would like to thank the Loyola senior class for granting me such a prestigious award. After 4 years, I can finally tell my parents that I put Father Linane's really relevant squeezing the sponge metaphor to good use. More importantly, I would like to thank Miss Fran from Iggy's for teaching me to never take life so seriously. So Thank you. I would also like to say this is a really good resume booster for me as I am trying to get into med school. So hopefully you trust all your kids with the class clown as your doctor. Yeah, that being said, Godspeed and roll hounds.
The second to last award of the night focuses on a core value of Loyola University, Maryland, that students are exposed to upon their first few days here on campus. This award is granted to the Loyola senior who embodies the Jesuit value of cura personalis, in that this individual truly exhibits care for the entire person and all of their relationships that they may have formed throughout their 4 years on this Evergreen campus. All five nominees of this award deserve to be recognized because they all have constantly made a conscious effort to not just acknowledge cura personalis, but rather to live by it, as it is a guiding principle for their individual Loyola experiences. I am truly honored to announce the nominees for the Cura Personalis Award: Grace Baltimore, Spencer Blair, Liam McDonald, Franklin Parks, and Emma Schiller. And the winner is Grace Baltimore.
Hi everyone, my name is Grace Baltimore and I want to thank you all for nominating me for the Cura Personalis Award. Not only does Cura Personalis mean to care for the whole self, but it also means to care for others. And while being at Loyola, I've had the pleasure of forming the best, most genuine relationships with friends, professors, mentors, and staff. And I truly just want to say to you all that you are so loved and I care for you all so much. And I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for all of you. So thank you. And thank you for just sharing your stories with me, being authentic, being intentional, and just always accepting me with love. It's so appreciated. I hope everyone does well after graduation, and I wish everyone just the best, and just remember that you all are loved. Peace.
While cura personalis is a key defining value of the Loyola community, caring for individuals is not limited to the boundaries of the Evergreen campus. The majority of the awards announced tonight directly involve people and things within the Loyola community. However, this 35th and final award involves the wider Baltimore community. More specifically, this award is granted to the senior who has been most dedicated to serving the Baltimore community throughout their time at Loyola. The recipient of this award has made it a priority to embrace the beauty and diversity of the city of Baltimore and have made an intentional effort to form relationships with its people. Additionally, all five nominees of this award should be congratulated for going above and beyond to commit themselves to becoming familiar with the history of Baltimore to ultimately bring about positive change in the community. It is with great honor and gratitude that I announce the nominees for the Servant Leadership Award: Grace Baltimore, Jamila Battle, Ahmed Jackson, Brendan O'Connell, and Sophia Riviello. And the winner is, well deserved, Sophia Riviello.
Hi everyone, Sophia Riviello here. I wanted to start off with thanking you guys for even considering my name for this award. I think that any actions that I took part in that may have got me nominated would just not have been possible without all of you. I feel so fortunate to have gotten to spend the past 4 years here calling Baltimore my home, and I'm a firm believer that you can't have a home without a family. So I just wanted to say that I've never failed to be amazed at how much you all cared for your home. And I know that some of us might be staying here, or others might be starting anew. And I can only say that I hope you guys care for the communities that you're going to be a part of as much as you've cared for Baltimore. I encourage you to continue uplifting the voices of those that may go unheard, supporting the people around you, supporting small businesses, women-owned businesses, and Black-owned businesses. And keep on caring, because caring is the coolest thing that you can do. Thank you.
And that concludes our program. I hope you enjoyed the show. Congratulations to all of our nominees and especially to the award recipients. Sorry if you didn't win the awards. Please don't hate me or SGA. It's just business. But also a big thank you to all of you who nominated, voted, and tuned in to the first ever Golden Greyhounds Senior Choice Awards. Though it won't replace anything we've lost throughout our senior year, I definitely think it was a way to go out with a bang at the end of our senior year right before graduation. And finally, a big thank you goes out to the Senior Assembly who made all of this possible. Sarah Thompson, our class of 2021's very own Sarah Thompson, if I may add, who created all the marketing for this event. And finally, biggest thank you goes to the best videographer and editor in the world, Jake Norris, who's behind the camera right now, for putting this all together and making it look good for you all. And two, the class of 2021, the best class in Loyola history. It has been an honor serving as your senior class president. I hope you and your families enjoy graduation tomorrow. I wish you all the best in your future endeavors. And last but not least, I love you all, and roll Hounds.